A question people ask about my machines from time to time is, what type of router did you use and where can I get it? The router that I used was a cheap router from Canadian Tire that comes with multiple bases. You can get routers with a fixed base and a cylindrical body like this from many manufacturers in North America. They all have a 3.5 inch or 89 millimeter body. Problem is, if you're outside of North America, you really can't get this style of router. And sometimes people ask if they can adopt a regular router, but the problem is one of these with its built-in handles and plastic case is really not suitable. But the thing is, for something like the slot mortiser or the pantorouter, we're going to be using much smaller bits like this, whereas the larger routers are designed to handle some bigger bits. So really, a small router such as this Bosch Colt should do the job as well. So I've got my templates here. And before I start using those, I'm going to check that those are accurate. So let's see, that looks like it all lines up. So now I've tacked down my templates with just a little bit of dabs of glue. Didn't want to use too much because that might stretch the paper and that would screw up the accuracy. Now I'm going to center punch some of the holes so that no matter what happens with the templates, I'll have those. The holes are really the main thing that is critical in terms of position. Let's do a fit check. Gotta make sure this all fits together. Okay, so that fits around the router just fine. And that fits around the back end, so good to go. So I've got my spacers prepared. So I've got all the parts here, it looks good. Just waiting for the glue on this to dry a bit more before I go on. So this is how the whole bracket is supposed to fit together. The problem is, if I glue all these pieces all together at once, getting everything aligned, especially this way, is very difficult. So what I'm going to do is just glue these pieces on, and then I'll glue that one on later. Now with these pieces all glued on, all I have to do is to line this piece up properly and glue it together. So I've got my framing square, I've propped it up a little bit so it's not going to hit the chamfer, and I'm going to bump both of those against here and then just eyeballing it to make sure this temporary shaft I stuck in here also looks completely parallel to that edge. So once I glue that together, hopefully it'll be all perfect. Well, that still looks like it's lined up. So now let's just let the glue dry and then it should be ready. Now with the glue dry, I gotta check this thing for alignment. So with these things the same height all along, if this were to rock back and forth here, then I'd have a twist problem, but looks like I'm okay. Now let's check that these shafts have got the same distance between them, and the right distance, so 24 centimeters both sides. So that's good. And now let's check that it's square. So I'm just looking down over it. That's good. So far it looks like I didn't goof this one up.
So for fitting the mounting brackets, I'm just going to put them on there and then tap those screws with a hammer, and that'll tell me where I can drill the pilot holes for the screws.
Now comes the tricky part of checking the alignment. So I've got a flat surface here, and these three blocks are all exactly the same width, so they come off the same height off the table. So now, supporting the router on the shafts off of those blocks, I can now check that this shaft comes out level with the table, and I can measure that just by measuring the height off of it, off the table. And then as I come out here, so that's actually, that's close enough. So I don't have to worry about that direction so much. Now I also want to make sure it's aligned in this direction. So I'm just going to put a square against here, and it seems to be off this way by about a millimeter. So let's see if I can just force that a little bit. Cool, now it's on. So this is the tricky part, that it may slip in the screws in here a little bit. And I may add some padding around the handle to give it support back here as well. And then a final check, just to make sure that it's in the middle between my two other holes. Yeah, same distance. Okay, so and it looks like it's about the right height. So this is good.
The back of this router, unfortunately, has got this sort of ergonomic handle profile shape, and only the front portion of it is cylindrical, so I don't really have that much to grab it by. But once I kind of knocked it in place to be aligned, what I've done is I've glued a couple of blocks here, which bump up against an outside corner here, which is going to give the router a bit of a back reference, and will hopefully keep it aligned, especially if I take it out of the jig and put it back in. Now, taking off the old router mount. Whoops! And now installing the mounting bracket for my palm router. Getting the washers in is really tricky, so what I do is I insert a shaft from either side, and then I put the washers on the ends of the shafts. Then the next thing is to pull the shafts back just barely far enough to fit the middle piece in between, but not far enough to drop the washers. And once the middle part is in between, just push one of the shafts all the way through, and that pushes the temporary shaft on the other side out. Now with just a straight shaft in the router, I'm checking that that shaft is level with the table across the whole range of motion. I'm also checking that it's 90 degrees with the edge of the table across the range of motion. I actually get more range of motion with the small router because it doesn't bump into the template frame quite as easily. Now putting on a half-inch router bit, I'm cutting a tenon in oak.